Let's discover the interface of Artboard Studio together. First, we need to start with the canvas. Artboard Studio has an infinite canvas. This means you can place or create any design elements all in one place. Easily move them around and work together with your vector, video, audio, and image assets. This also means that you may have lots of design elements on your canvas, but don't worry, because we have a very similar user experience with other freeform canvas tools like Adobe Illustrator, Figma, Sketch, or Framer, and many handy shortcuts for you to navigate around and be more creative. Any part of your freeform canvas can be the zone for your inspirations, for your assets, or for your designs. For navigating inside the canvas and jump to other parts, you can press and hold space key, click and drag the mouse. This way, you can have a bird's eye view on your entire infinite canvas. If you want to zoom into a specific part of your canvas, simply press Command or Control key, and use the mouse wheel to zoom in and out. If you press Shift and 1, it will show all content on your canvas and fit them all into the viewport. If you select something on your canvas and then press Shift and 2, it will zoom into the object or artboard selected. Let's create a new artboard. Go to the left toolbar and activate the artboard tool or press A, and then draw your artboard anywhere you like. You can move the artboard, change the size anytime you want. You can use bounding boxes around the artboard for resizing or enter any number from the right sidebar. You can also choose from predefined artboard sizes from this menu. Also, switch ratio from these little icons. If you enable the lock icon here, it will automatically resize based on width or height and keep the ratio. You can create unlimited amount of artboards. They work like containers for your design elements. If you place something inside this artboard and open the layers menu, you will see all objects listed here. If there is an artboard on your canvas and there are objects inside, you will see these objects nested inside the artboard. Once you select an artboard on your canvas, you will see all properties on the right sidebar. Other than resizing options, you will see alignment, fill color, grid, and export sections here. For applying a color, gradient, or pattern as background, simply click the color box on the fill section and define any style you like. If you add a grid, you can basically add guidelines to your artboard and they are not visible in the export. Can be used as reference lines. You can also change the color or type from the right sidebar. From the export section, you can export as image, video, or HTML all the content on your artboard. If you have animation or video inside your artboard, the video section will be activated. If there is no animation or video, you will be able to export your design as SVG, PNG, WebP, and JPEG. You can also choose resolution and add suffix to your file names if you are exporting several artboards. In the video export section, you can have MP4, GIF, and WebM formats. Also, you can define frame rates from this input. You can go up to 60 frames per second for your video exports. In the HTML export section, you can get display advertising network ready HTML exports from your designs. You will get a zip file with all image and assets as HTML5 and ready to use within Google Display Network or even on your website. For exporting your videos or images, you can also use Export menu next to the artboard titles. Let's go back to the left toolbar and discover the Add Item menu. This menu includes all assets for your design process. Templates from various categories, mockup items, stock photos, or videos will be accessible here. Simply drag and drop any content to your canvas. The mockups menu includes individual mockup items from lots of different categories. You can make a search or browse categories to find the best mockup item to place your own design. The best part of our mockup items, they are all matching with each other. If you add items from the same perspective, you can easily generate realistic mockup scenes with additional props or decorative items. The Layers panel on the left toolbar shows you a list of objects and artboards on your canvas. You can easily change the item orders, tag them with colors, lock, or hide them from here. Artboard Studio is a vector-based graphic and motion design tool, so we have all tools for you to create basic or complex shapes easily. You can easily create star, rectangle, ellipse, polygon, or line from this menu. After you draw a shape on your canvas, again, you can select and go to the right sidebar to change the properties. The text tool basically adds text elements to your canvas. Again, after you create a text object anywhere on your canvas, You can go to the right sidebar and change the font family, style anytime you like. Also, Artboard Studio has a text on pad tool, which you can type text on any vector pad or shape. The pen tool lets you to create vector illustrations. You can create vector shapes from scratch or import SVG files and edit vector points easily. The best part, you can also animate these vector illustrations. With the pencil tool, you can create freeform vector lines mostly for annotating specific parts on your canvas for your teammates. Artboard Studio is the best design tool for automation, and the table tool is one of the most handy features. You can draw tables, enter text, image or color data, and connect to design elements, and then generate bulk designs based on your data feed table. Also, you can import tables from Google Sheets or use Shopify store links to import product lists to your canvas as a table and then connect them to design elements. The assets menu is for organizing your brand assets. You can upload your brand files and define guidelines and easily import into your canvas. This way, you can make all of your designs consistent and matching to your brand. The help menu includes all detailed tutorial videos. The best part, you can import videos as pop-ups and move them around inside the canvas. Easily repeat and learn steps one by one by following the videos. At the very bottom of the interface, we have Timeline Editor. If you enable the Start Animating button after selecting the artboard, you can create keyframes and create motion graphics easily. You can create auto keyframes by making changes on your artboard, or use the right sidebar inputs to create or update keyframe values. Artboard Studio also has lots of amazing effects and automation tools on the top bar. The Smart Object tool creates instances or copies from artboards. So if you change the main artboard, it will automatically update all instances. The Warp Transform allows you to distort image or videos with deformation points. You can add deformation points and drag them around to manipulate the shape of the video or image on your canvas. The Perspective Transform gives you 4 points around the image or video layers to manipulate the perspective of objects. The Remove Background tool simply removes the background from your photos. It also gives you options to modify your selection and make advanced editing for removing the background from your photos. The masking menu contains 3 different masking options to place images or videos inside rasterized or vector objects. The vector masking menu does the masking for vector shapes. You can combine or exclude vector shapes from each other. The blend tool enables you to merge 2 shapes as a single shape with steps. The best part of that, you can also animate blend effect and get eye-catching and unique abstract animations. The typewriter effect only works with text layers and gives you typewriting motion effect. You can change the speed by moving the keyframes. The Animate on Pad menu creates position keyframes on a specific vector pad. You can move objects along a pad and decide the pad with your own vector shape. Other than the top bar effects menu, we also have transform effect on the right sidebar. When you select an object from your canvas, you can easily create duplicates and clones based on specific position or rotation. Another great automation feature is Pin to Edge. You can define design elements positions, and once you change the size of the artboard, design elements will adapt to the new size automatically. On the right top, you will see Share menu. Here, you can share your projects as link or invite people to your projects to work together by just typing their email address. And lastly, on the top right corner, you have view options for zooming or changing the interface theme from light to dark. Additionally, for keyboard shortcuts, you can go to the top left corner and open the keyboard shortcuts menu here. Also, see some functions listed here inside this menu. Artboard Studio has a powerful right-click menu which, based on the object you select on your canvas, you can see additional functions here listed with shortcut information. So, now you learned all the basics of Artboard Studio interface. Let's create something amazing today and experience the Artboard Studio for free. Simply visit artboard.studio now and get started.